We've been engaging in virtual training on several of these issues. We were doing in-person training on those issues prior to the coronavirus hitting. You know, as a result of the virus, we've had to change many of the things we are doing. We are doing virtual debates. We're doing virtual training. We held our convention virtually to select delegates. And all of those, of course, raised the risk of cybersecurity. All of those issues we've dealt with in various ways. We've consulted with IT people, with experts that have helped us. And we have not so far encountered any issues with that. We hope to keep it that way, but we're taking active steps to do that. But it's been quite a change to have to do so much virtually and with very little notice. I mean, we had to completely change the way we do business, the way we run our state party overnight. It was a very quick learning process in order to be successful at it. And we've had some success at it. We've been doing chairman chats. We have to do those virtually where we invite guests in and have discussions. And those have been very popular. And again, there hasn't been any problem with those that we know of so far. So we're just continuing to do the work that we do just through a different form, different medium. Fortunately, in Kansas, we've had we've made it very simple for people to vote for years here. We allow absentee voting. It's a pretty simple process to do that. One of the chief concerns we have with this mass mailing concept, of course, is security. We have an obligation in the state to make people feel secure and that they can rely on the integrity of our elections. And the more we loosen that up and engage in this kind of mass mailing, the more we raise concerns for people in the public about the integrity of our elections. And that, I think, has to be first and foremost. People have to be able to trust our elections. Fortunately, in Kansas, we're not considered a densely populated state. So right now, even today, we're seeing lots of people out. People are going to restaurants. People are going to grocery stores. People are just being cautious. But people are going on with their everyday lives. From my perspective, I don't see polling places being any different than that. People are going to grocery stores. People are going to restaurants. People are going to all kinds of services that they need. Asking people that want, you know, that don't want to take advantage of the absentee ballot process, letting them go to a polling place, it doesn't seem to be a big stretch. I do not participate in absentee ballot. I prefer to go to a polling place. There's just something about election day and participating and going to your polling place and being a part of that that's important to a lot of people. And we need to make sure that that continues to be a part of it. The excitement of an election day, going to the polling place, that brings people out. It shows the importance of it. This isn't just something we should be taking for granted or something that isn't important. It is a very important thing to vote. And so we want to keep pushing that. We are steps ahead in Kansas, like I said, with the absentee process. You didn't have to give a reason for the last several years. You've been able to sign up to vote absentee. And we've made it quite easy to vote in this state. So I would say, you know, that combined with taking steps to ensure the integrity so people trust our results is primary concern.